possibly about 12 meters off the speed being dictated by Grant Hackett of Australia. 20-year-old from the Gold Coast. Behind him, the 27-year-old, looking to make history.
Dennis Cottrell, Grant Hackett's coach, and John Carew, Kieren Perkins' coach, both from Queensland. This is really the race of their lives as well. John Carew's done it twice before, Perkins in 92 and 96. This is the first time for Cottrell.
Hackett, right, a couple of metres now. Perkins in lane four, the fastest qualifier, under 15 minutes yesterday. He was delighted. As we go through 600, 551.9, Hackett in front. Perkins clinging on. Expectations were high coming in, and they're still very high at the Sydney International Aquatic Centre. There's a buzz around this stadium. Across in seven, Thompson still clearly third. He's having a great swim so far. Can he maintain?
Now, from indications I'm getting from the splits, this is looking like it will be a sub-14.50 swim.
Wow.
Now, every now and again, you see Kieren Perkins breaking the two-beat kick and moving into a four-beat kick. That is unusual for Kieren. But as I said earlier, it's smart swimming by him. He cannot let Grant Hackett away too much. If he does, Grant will start to build his confidence and pull away even further. So Kieren needs to stay in touch, and that's exactly what he's doing.
It's a question about control as far as Kieren Perkins is concerned. Around he goes in second place. Hackett's time through 700, 651.9. How much does Perkins have left? How much too does Hackett have left? Approaching halfway. Next turn, the halfway mark in this event. Just get the feeling the cadence from Perkins has increased. The tempo suddenly has gone up. He's trying to get closer now. Hackett around. Perkins goes now.
Well, this is starting to get toward the business end of this particular 1500. And the arms would start to be hurting. The lactic acid would be building. The legs would be burning. And as I've said earlier, the stomach starts to really tighten up. And as we saw in 1991, Kieren Perkins finished and he nearly brought up his lunch because it's the toughest race on the calendar. And that's why the whole of Australia is watching today to see our two great champions go head to head.
The Americans, third and fourth. Thompson ahead of Vent. Neathling in fifth place. The action across in the center of the pool. Kieren Perkins in lane four, swimming at the feet of Grant Hackett, the world champion.
Now, to me at this stage, Grant just looks like he's just slipped back a little bit. Still well ahead of Kieren, but I think Kieran's just picking up a little bit of ground. And Grant's still working his turns well, but Grant just looks to me at this stage of the race like he's just dropped ever so slightly in the water. Now, there could be two reasons for that. One of them is he is getting tired, or number two is he could be settling into a rhythm, ready to and setting himself up to really build up in the last 500.
Both breathing to their right. So Hackett looking across at Perkins through 900, 851.36. Perkins in second place. Hackett is turning well, coming off the wall that time, increased his margin on Kieren Perkins.
Kieren looks like he's just fatiguing a little bit here. He's got to maintain his stroke pattern, maintain his rhythm, push out the back of the stroke, and can't let Grant go.
Maybe, just maybe, he sent the message a day too early. Hackett increasing his lead now. He's up the tempo. Perkins tried to get him on the previous lap, had no success. And now the counterpunch comes from Hackett. Suddenly the margin two body lengths. Perkins in second place. Thompson, the American, third. Vent would be fourth. Neathling is fifth. Across in lane two, Philippe is next best. A personal best of 15.07.76. Philippe was fourth in Perth. Look at Hackett coming down to 1,000 metres.
It's a 951.35. They're still looking, it's still looking like it's going to be a sub-14.50 swim.
And the interesting thing is the roar will inspire them both. The two Australians in front. Hackett from Perkins. Nothing much has changed, only over the last 200 metres the lead has become a little bigger.
Now they have dropped off their earlier pace. Grant surged in the previous 100. He looks like he's just dropped away again. And he's trying to settle himself into rhythm. He's got to be careful not to surge and drop away, because that can affect... I know I keep harping on rhythm, but that's what it's all about in these 1500s. And if you keep varying your pace, it can take a lot of energy away from yourself, especially for that last 100.
This will be 1100 metres. The challenge now with Kieren Perkins. The crowd sensing it. Hackett around first. 10.50.99. Perkins around now. 10.54.27. That's the margin. The two Americans stroke for stroke about 15 metres away. Thompson just shading Bent.
Okay, now Grant's lifted slightly here. He's started to drop his pace a little bit. Sorry, increase his pace a little bit. And he's pulling away from Kieren. This is the crunch of the race. This is where this race will be won and lost.
Hackett passes Perkins on his way back. Grant Hackett lifting the tempo again. Putting the challenge to Perkins now. Can Perkins respond? He has every other time. He realizes that Hackett has increased his lead to about 4 or 5 metres now, coming down to 1,200. After this, just 300 to swim. Of course, Perkins, the silver medalist in the 400 in Barcelona, a long time ago. He needs something now. He needs something special. Hackett's in front, though. Grant Hackett.
I have to say, it's fantastic to see the Australians here in the stadium cheering Aussie, because they want to see Australia go 1-2, and that's what it's all about here in this 1500. We did it in 92, first and second. We did it in 96, first and second. Can we do it here in 2000?
Hackett goes around. Passes Perkins, coming back yet again. This could be a decisive break now. Hackett working hard, strong in the water, driving. Perkins appears a little labored back in second place. Coming down to 1,300 metres. Hackett from Perkins.
Grant's just dropped his kick slightly and he just picked it up again there. Now Kieran's going to have to make a move now if he's going to get anywhere near Grant Hackett. It's 1,300, 200 to go.
Listen to that roar. The crowd urging both the Australians on. Came here today expecting gold and silver. They want it. They want it badly. I don't think many of them cared who came first and who came second.